Good morning. Now here it is Friday. I'm going to do a real quick little thing. A couple of weeks ago I did a thing they call a hat trick. And I showed you how to use put a quarter 20 nut on a pencil and just put it as a magnet, put a little magnet clip on the hat. I showed you how to do that a couple of weeks ago. What I didn't mention was these little magnets. Can you see these magnets, Vicki? You got a good picture of those? Okay, now these magnets are just, I don't know how many you get for just a few dollars on Amazon, but they're not very expensive. And when you buy enough of them to do your hat trick, then I'll show you something else you can do. I should have showed you before, but take just a regular screwdriver. And can you see this? It's got a little bit of magnetism to it because I've used it a couple times. But if you stick a magnet, one of these little magnets to that thing, it becomes a real magnetic screwdriver. So you don't have to go to all the trouble of magnetizing your screwdrivers. If you just get some of these little disc rare earth magnets, and it becomes a magnetic screwdriver. So that's all I wanted to show you. It's just it gives you another use for these little magnets. And they're pretty handy to have. And they're kind of fun to play with too. So anyway, that's all I wanted to do today. Now my son will take over and he's got some stuff he wants to show you on layout, but that's all you get from me for today. I got other stuff to do. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Okay, so now it is my turn. Dad did a great job showing you how to magnetize your screwdrivers or whatever. So what I'm going to do today is something that is kind of a redo of something I did a couple years ago. Gosh, what did I do with my little piece of paper? Yeah, back on 9/12/15, I did a video called A New Transfer Process, and it was actually an LTS. And I kind of showed a transfer process. Now, you guys know that lately I've been doing the carving through paper or through vinyl with masking tape underneath using the spray adhesive and packing tape on top, and that works. I don't have any problems with it, but I know some of you may be having some issues with that. So I want to share, kind of revisit that video that I did a year and a half ago, and kind of show you a little bit more that I've learned actually and gotten a little bit better at it. And I've got to give credit to, I've heard this a couple times, but specifically Morgan Stoltz over in Sweden, that he and I have been friends for, gosh, he's been watching for like 8 or 9 years now, and sent me a little video. And he's posted a video on YouTube. In fact, I'll put a link to it in the description down below. But he's using a little transfer tool and a laser jet printer, and I want to kind of show you a new way that if you haven't seen before that you can get your image on your board. So first of all, you guys know I'm a big Tombstone fan. We did this a few weeks ago with Joe from Joe's Average Joe's Joinery. Forgot it for a second, but anyway, yeah. So what I want to do today is I'm not going to do any carving, but I'm going to show you this transfer process. So we have a little image here, and this is reversed. So the first thing that I want to say is there's a website that I found, and I've known about it for a while, but now I'm using it a little bit different. It's called Rapid Resizer, and many of you probably already know about it. And I'm going to do another video completely on how to use that, and I'm learning more about it every day, but it's really a cool website, guys. It is awesome what it will do. So maybe next week, one of next week's videos, we'll get to the end of the computer and I'll show exactly what I've kind of learned, and I think there's a ton more that I need to learn on it, but I can definitely, that's how I printed this out and was able to flop it and reverse it. So Here's the first thing we're going to do. This is done with a laser printer, and I'm going to put this this transfer onto this board. So, babe, if you can kind of zoom down. What I'm going to do is, let me get this out of the way. I am going to just, and I'm just kind of not taking any measurements or anything, but I can kind of see that image through there. I'm just going to masking tape it down. You can tape it down with Scotch tape or packing tape, whatever you want, but I'm just going to tape it in place. Make sure that I can flip it up and flip it down. And again, Morgan's video is really good on this process as well. And it's only a few minutes long. I'm going to try and keep this fairly short. So now I've got this little transfer tool. And I used this before on that old video that I told you about. And I'll put a link to that in the description as well. But it's really a neat little tool. You can use an iron, but I like this transfer tool a little bit better. And I'm going to show you a couple different ways to do this, but basically all you're doing, and this has been burning now for, I don't know, probably 15, 20 minutes, so it's really hot. These things will really burn you, by the way, if you're not careful. But you can see how that thing's kind of starting to transfer over. So you just keep it moving in a short circular motions, and then as Morgan said on his video, just keep lifting it and going back and forth. And I'm going to go through this pretty quick because I've got two or three of them that I want to do here. But you've got to get that thing hot in that one area. And you can see that it transfers pretty easy, pretty neat. But let me show you what I really discovered. So I could go through that and see where that is kind of light in there. I can go through and concentrate and get more of that ink down. So you can see kind of how that works. But here's what I really liked. See, that's not too bad. And you can work with it and make it better. But I want to move on to the next part. So what I'm going to let that heat up a little bit more. Turn it this way?
Well, just so, yeah.
Sorry about that, guys. Our card got full, so we had to kind of, we'll have to splice this together. But anyway, what I was saying is that this actually transfers pretty well. It's not bad. But what I discovered, here's one that I had done earlier, the same kind of way. And it looks okay. I could actually go over it again and get it darker if I wanted, but what I realized is that, and you'll see this in Morgan's video, what I realized is in that program I was talking about, Rapid Resizer, you can actually make your images a little bit different. You can make them just outline. Okay, so what I'm going to do, again, this is done with a laser printer, so I am going to, let me see, I'm going to move that out of the way. So this is the one that I did earlier, and that was with everything colored in. This is the one I just did. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this over, and we're going to transfer this one. Again, I'm just eyeballing this guy, so if I was making an actual sign here, I would be, you know, taking measurements, making sure it's centered and, you know, and square and straight and all that. But here's what I'm going to do, just for time-wise. So now I'm going to take that same deal. And check that out. Being as it doesn't have all that, and this is a way to save ink too, and I think in Rapid Resizer, that's how I kind of found this, is to save ink. Now you guys may have a program, you know, Print Shop or Photoshop or I don't know, there's so many different programs out there that you may be able to do this and mirror image and flop and then do a line, like an ink saver kind of thing. So I'm not saying rapid resizer is the only way to go. It's just what I found, and it's super easy to use. I'm not a big software guy, but it's super easy to use. I really, really like it. And again, I'll do a whole video on that thing. Vicki and I will get into the office, and we'll do a whole video on it. So wherever it's light, you can just kind of just keep working it. And so then once this image is all done, then you can go back and say, okay, what's going to be filled in, what's going to be wood color, and what's going to be carved in. I'm trying to kind of rush here, but basically you can see, like, in that area right there, if I really kind of concentrate, I'm not putting a lot of pressure on it, but I'm just getting that hot. See how that line came out really cool? So this is what I would suggest, is if you're going to do this, you know, use that feature, that saving ink kind of feature, and just get yourself a line, because that's really all you need to go by. And this is in the context, obviously, of making signs, you guys. So if you're doing, you know, guys that normally, or people that normally do this, they're doing other things with this. But I use it in context of actually being able to follow a line and carve a sign out of it. So again, see where that's real light through there? Be careful with this thing, by the way, guys. It will burn you really good. See how cool that is? It really comes out nice. So this line feature, I just think that's so much better than the other one that I did, whereas it, you know, it's that one there. It just is a lot easier to do. It doesn't use as much ink, and I would just probably go back with a Sharpie and say, okay, I want that black, I want that black, and just make some marks in there. In fact, I didn't even think about it, but I would probably just do something like this. Okay, that's going to be black, that's going to be black, that's going to be black, you know, and go back and just, you know, do that. So now, that is if you have a laser printer, that's one way to go. Now I'm going to give you another option. Let's say you've got an inkjet printer. Well, you can do the same thing, but what I've printed it on is I printed it on iron-on transfer paper. So if you've got an inkjet, you can use the iron-on transfer paper, and let me show you how that works. We'll just put it on this board. So I think, and back in that old video that I'm referencing, back that I did in September of 2015, that LTS, that's where I used this transfer paper, and I was carving a little image of a bass jumping out of the water kind of thing. So this is how the transfer paper works. So again, inkjet, transfer paper, laser jet is just the regular paper. Now the thing about this transfer paper is it kind of leaves a film on there. You can see it kind of is leaving a little bit of a film on there. But honestly, when you go back and watch that other video that I did, it really doesn't interfere with the routing at all. The router base just kind of goes right over the top of it, so it's not really an issue. Now see, the way you need to work this is just kind of lifting it and heating it at the same time. Make sure that you've got that film heated under there. See how that works? It actually works pretty darn good. So it just gives you guys an option. If you don't have a laser printer, you can just get some of this heat-on, iron-on transfer paper, and you can buy it on Amazon. You can get it probably at Staples.
You can get it at Walmart.
You can get it at Walmart, you know, so you can get expensive stuff, you can get cheap stuff, but so you'll have to play around with it and see what works for you. I can go back and heat that back up. So it actually comes out pretty nice, not too bad. So I don't know, I'm kind of, If I had to pick one or the other, and I've got a laser printer, which I do now, I probably would go the laser printer with just regular paper. But if you don't have access to a laser printer and you've got an inkjet and you can pick up some of this iron-on transfer paper, it certainly does work. And it's probably, I would say, if I had to guess, I would say it's easier, less problems to carve than, now see, it leaves that kind of that stuff on there, but that really doesn't matter. Your router is going to go right over the top of that. So there's another way that you can get that image on there with an inkjet. And I would just take a little piece of sandpaper and just, you know, but you can see it sticks on there and your router is going to ride right over the top of that. So that's a way you can use an inkjet if you don't have a laser jet. Here's one I did. So again, here's another one that I did earlier. This is laser jet. Obviously, I just threw it on there. I didn't square up the letters. And here's another one that I did. And this was with the inkjet and the transfer paper. So it's a great way, different way to get your image on the board. And honestly, I'll probably start using this a little bit more. And once you learn more about that that website, or it, maybe, you know, again, maybe you've got a software that will do what this rapid resizer will do, but I'm telling you, it's cool. And I think we'll maybe do that on Monday.
We're up here.
Okay, so I think maybe we'll do that on Monday, show you guys that that rapid resizer and what I'm doing with it in order to get it to do these different kinds of things. And it's also good for big signs, not just little images like that. It's really good for big signs as well. So it's rapidresizer.com, and it is it does so many different things, but it is a paid website. But I'll kind of go into that a little bit more on Monday. Today, I just wanted to show this transfer process. So I hope this was helpful. Again, thank you again for Morgan Stoltz. He kind of pushed me. Thank you for pushing me to get this done. It's something I've been wanting to do and redo for quite a while now. But so thank you for pushing me to really play around with this and get it better. Now the one thing, and you'll see this on Morgan's video too, you've got to make sure your board is smooth. That's the mistake I was making. I was just rough sanded with my belt sander, and so as soon as I used a vibrator sander and got it down smoother, that made a huge difference too from how the image sticks to the board. So anyway, guys, I hope this is helpful. Thanks again for everything, all of the support and the likes and everything. If you have questions on this, yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Do you still put sanding sealer on your boards before you...
Good question. So that's one thing I still have to kind of play around with. These don't have sanding sealer on them, so I know how it works without sanding sealer on them, but I've got to play around with it, and I'll let you know in the future. Thank you for throwing that out there. I'll let you know in the future how this stuff sticks with the sanding sealer on the pine that I normally always put sanding sealer on. So I'll get back to you on that and let you know how that works. That's my next kind of group of experiments. So anyway, guys, have a great weekend. Thanks again. I hope this was helpful, and we'll see you guys on Monday morning for coffee and questions. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.